الحمد لله الذي هدانا للإيمان وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله بعث بالدين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون. اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، الله سبحانه وتعالى tells us in سورة آل عمران: قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم والله غفور رحيم. For reflecting the meaning of this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling Prophet Muhammad, قل إن كنتم تحبون الله, to tell people, if you love Allah, فاتبعوني, to follow Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when we follow him, يحببكم الله, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would love you, ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم, and he will forgive your sins, والله غفور رحيم, Allah is forgiving and merciful. The reason I mentioned this ayah is a friend of ours brought to our attention on the weekend the first speech of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Al-Madina. The first Jum'ah was held in Al-Madina because there was no Jum'ah prayer before Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to Al-Madina. So in his first speech, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the second half of the speech, tells us, أحبوا ما أحب الله. Love what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. Subhanallah. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم is telling us to love what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. أحبوا الله من كل قلوبكم. Love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with all your hearts. ولا تملوا كلام الله وذكره. And do not get bored from the words of Allah. The words of Allah is the Quran. وذكره is remembering and mentioning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا تَقْسُ عَنْهُ قُلُوبُكُمْ. And your heart should not be hard. These are the main parts of the speech of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أحبوا ما أحب الله. Love what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. And the ayah says, if you love Allah, follow Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you. So we have to ask ourselves, what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love? Because when we love somebody, we want to please them and we want to do the things that please them and make them happy. And here our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us, first Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those who are charitable, those who improve themselves. Subhanallah. So we have to first try to be among them ourselves, to try to improve and be charitable ourselves, and then we find those who are muhsineen and love them. Same as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves them, we should love them. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in other ayat, إن الله يحب التوابين ويحب المتطهرين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those who ask for forgiveness, tawab, ويحب المتطهرين, those who clean themselves. Not just their body, they clean their body, their heart, their spirit, everything. So inshallah, we have to try to be among them ourselves, to go and do tawbah in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to cleanse our heart and soul and body and clothing. And now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us another ayah, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those who observe him and know that he's there and watch Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الصَّابِرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those who are patient. If there is problems or issues, to have to be patient. And that's where Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, عَجِبْتُ لَأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ كُلَّ أَمْرُ خَيْرٍ. I admire the matters of the believers. Everything for them is good. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them and they thank Allah, it's good for them. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala holds, then they are patient, it's good for them. So Allah يُحِبُّ الصَّابِرِينَ. So if we're going through a tough time, we have to be patient, inshallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَوَكِّلِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those who rely on him and leave everything in the hands of Allah. Most of us, we want to do things ourselves, and only when we fail, we say تَوَكَّلْتُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. تَوَكُّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ is we start by تَوَكُّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ and then we do our best. Because everything is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا النَّصْرُ إِلَّا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ. Victory is from Allah. So we start by تَوَكُّلْ and then do our best because we try. But it is توكل على الله. إن الله يحب المقسطين. Allah سبحانه وتعالى loves those who are fair, those who are just. Subhanallah. So we have to be ourselves fair and just, and then we have to find those who are fair and just, and we love them too. Just like a Rasul said, أحب ما أحب الله. Love what Allah سبحانه وتعالى loves. And then ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. Those who follow and dedicate themselves to Allah, لا خوف عليهم. We should not be afraid for them. ولا هم يحزنون. And they should not be sad. So what else does Allah سبحانه وتعالى love? إن الله يحب إذا عمل أحدكم عملا أن يتقنه. If one of us do a deed, he has to do it well, subhanallah. And we have to ask ourselves as Muslims, is this our motto in life? إِنَّ اللَّهُ يُحِبَّ مَنْ عَمَلَ مِنْكُمْ عَمْلًا يَتْقِنَ. A lot of us only do a good job if somebody is watching them. But if nobody is watching them, they don't bother to do a good job. Where here, we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching everybody. And إِنَّ اللَّهُ يُحِبَّ مَنْ عَمَلَ عَمَلَكُمْ إِذَا عَمَلَ عَمَلَكُمْ أَحَدُكُمْ عَمَلًا أَنْ يَتْقِنَ. And do a good job. Whatever we do, if we're students, we have to study well and we have to be ahead. If we work, whatever we do in life, as a parent, we have to take good care of our children. Everything is we have to do well. We cannot do it quickly and say nobody's watching, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching us all the time. And Rabi' al-Adawiyya tells us, the person talks with what he loves. If we love Allah, we'll be talking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. Or we'll be reading the Quran all the time. A lot of us, we love hockey. You find somebody talking about hockey all the time. Whatever you go, he's talking about his favorite sports, because that's what he loves. And those who love Allah, you find them talking about Allah, and you find talking about the wonders and miracles of Allah, and they're reciting and reading the Quran all the time. And as we said, you know, people ask Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib, how do we know, are we people of the dunya or people of al-akhirah? Do we love al-dunya or do we love al-akhirah? He said it's very simple. If a rich man comes and you do a simple test. If a rich man comes and visit you and a poor man comes and visit you, which one would you be happy to see? If you're happy to see the rich person, you love al-dunya because you're seeing al-dunya coming to you. If you're happy that a poor person is coming to visit you, you love al-akhirah because he's bringing you thawab. By giving to him and donating to him, you're bringing thawab. So it's a simple test. We ask ourselves, who are we happy to meet? Who are we pleased to see? Simple test to tell us who we are and what do we love. And Abu Dharr al-Ghafari told Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the man loves people, but maybe he cannot do what they do. So Allah Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, who do you love, Abu Dharr? So he said, I love Allah wa Rasulah. I love Allah and his messenger. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, فَإِنَّكَ مَعَ مَنْ أَحْبَبْتْ. You are with those you love. So we have to ask ourselves, what do we love? Who do we love? Because inshallah in al-akhirah we'll be with those. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, يُبْعَثُ الْمَرْءُ عَلَى مَا يُحِبُّ. We will be sent in the day of judgment with what we love. If somebody is going around saying democracy, he'll find himself in the day of judgment calling democracy. Somebody is likes communism or socialist, and he's standing in the dunya saying socialist or communism is the best thing. In al-akhirah, you find him talking about socialist and communism. And those who love Allah, they are talking about Allah in al-akhirah. يُبْعَثُ الْمَرْءُ عَلَى مَا يُحِبُّ. You will be sent with what we love. We have to ask ourselves, what do we love? What do we care for? And we know from this, inshallah. And then if we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but the love of Allah is a two-way street that starts with the love of Allah before we love Allah. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or the scholars tells us there are three things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts. It says in the Quran, يَحُبُّهُمُ اللَّهُ يَحُبُّونَ. Allah loves them and then they love Allah. وَرَضَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضَوْا عَنْهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is satisfied with the people and then they're satisfied with them, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the third thing is, the third thing, تَابَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ لِيَتُوبُوا. For somebody to ask for forgiveness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tab Allah alayhi first. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens the door of forgiveness for him. So he asks for a tawbah. So the three things, it starts by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loving a person, is Allah loves them, and then the person loves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as we said before, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves a person, he tells Gibril, I love this person, love him. And then Gibril announces in heaven and earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves this person, so love this person. And then yuktab lahu al-qubula fil ard. Acceptance is written for him on this earth. Acceptance is this thing when you think you have a bad problem and you go and somebody tells you, don't worry, I'll solve it for you. Subhanallah. And you might say, I was lucky I met a friend who said, don't worry, I was lucky somebody helped me. It isn't luck. It is the qubul, this acceptance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we want to do something, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends us somebody to make it easy. This is qubul al-ard, and this is the one of the signs that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves this person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبْ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلْ حَتَّى أُحِبُّهُ. My servant keeps approaching me with the extras. The nawafil is the extra sunnah, the extra fasting, the extra charity. Whatever extras we do, the extra umrahs, all these things are extras. And we keep doing this for the sake of Allah. And Allah says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, my servant keeps approaching me with all this extra till I love him. فَإِذَا أَحْبَبْتُ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the person, كُنْتُ سَمْعُهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِهِ. I become his hearing that he hears with. I become his eyesight that he sees with. I become his hands that he hits with. I become his feet that he walks with. And إذا سألني لعطيته. And if he asks me, I will give him. ولئن استعذني لعيزه. If he seeks refuge with me, I will refuge him. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, subhanallah, this wonderful thing that says, and I don't hesitate of doing something as much as I hesitate taking the soul of Abdi al-Mu'min, the servant, the believer, the servant that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَا تَرَدَّتْ. I did not hesitate as much as, but this is when he dies, it is written, and subhanallah, يَكْرَهُ الْمَوْتِ, he's saying that the people hate to die, وَأَكْرَهُ مُسَاءَتُهُ, and I hate to harm him, but it is, we all have to die, subhanallah. And that's why when Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in his deathbed, Gibril alayhi salam came and gave him a choice. He said, it is time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you a choice, you can die now, or you can live forever. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, what do you think, Jibril? So he said, we miss you in heaven. So he said, and I miss Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala too. Now is the time. So here, subhanallah, Allah gave a Rasul the option. And he chose to be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So here, if we love Allah and we approach Allah, Allah will love us and he helps us in everything we do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, Allah subhanahu, Rasul tells us that Allah gives the money to who he loves and who he doesn't love. A good mu'min could be rich, a bad kafir could be rich. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives iman only to those that Allah loves. So if somebody is a good mu'min, we know that Allah, it's a sign that Allah loves him, inshallah. فَإِذَا أَحَبَّ عَبْدًا أَعْطَاهُ الْإِيمَانِ. If Allah loves somebody, he gives him the iman, the faith. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, all the children of Adam commit mistakes, and the best of those who commit mistakes is those who ask for forgiveness. So let's pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask for his forgiveness. Alhamdulillah, wa shahadu an la ilaha illallah, wa shahadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. And we carry on with hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ahibbu ma ahabba Allah, loves what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. And we stress on some of the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. So this hadith, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, ثلاثة يحبهم الله وثلاثة يبغضهم الله. Three groups of people Allah loves and three groups of people Allah does not love or hates. So it says the first is a person came to some people begging. And we see this all the time. Somebody says, I'm out of town and I lost my money. So I say, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describes what most of us do. Is we ask, where are you from? Where did you come? Where did you lose the money? And then among themselves, they agree he's probably not worthy, and they decide not to give him. And then Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describes one of this group. holding back and going and gives this person money for the sake of Allah. And this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. So here we realize this scene a lot, but giving for the sake of Allah, Allah loves this person rather than say he doesn't deserve. And we all lived this scene before, but the person who gives for the sake of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. The second is a person who's been traveling all day, and traveling, whether it's in the old days or nowadays, if you travel all day, you're tired. And when you reach the destination tired, you want to go to sleep. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describing the scene of this group reached the destination, and they reached their camp, and all of them fell asleep, except one person did wudu and sat worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, this is a person Allah loves. And the third person Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves says, an army was fighting, and the army is defeated, and most of those who didn't die are withdrawing. Except one person says, I will go and attack the enemy. If I die, I die. If I don't, I open a gap in the enemy's line. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, this is the person Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. As for those Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dislikes, a shaykh al-zani, the old person that commits adult, wal faqir al-mukhtal, the poor person that's doing proud, and you find sometimes a poor person who wants to spend some money to show off. Subhanallah, you know, he doesn't have the money, but he wants to show off all the time. This is al-faqir al-mukhtal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like this person. And the third person, al-ghani al-zaloom, a rich person who is unjust and unfair to somebody. He has a lot of money, and yet he wants to take money from somebody else and inflict injustice on somebody else. So these are the three groups that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like. And as we said before, there's a man going to visit another man in another village. So he stopped by an angel, and the angel asked him, where are you going? I'm going to visit the brother and so on. So well, the angel asks him, do you do business with him? He says, no. Does he owe you money? No. Is he a relative? No. They says, why bother to go and visit him? Subhanallah, because nowadays people only visit people or call people when they need something. The phone only rings these days because somebody needs something. Or somebody come to visit you, they say they're coming to visit you for the sake of Allah, but we know they need something, subhanallah. So here, this brother who's going to visit his other the other brother, and the angel asks him, is it business? Is it money? Is it whatever? No. So he tells him, look up, and he sees a big palace in Al-Jannah, and he says, this is for you, for visiting your brother for the sake of Allah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, visiting a brother for the sake of Allah gets this palace. And then, some scholars tell us, is religion other than the love of Allah? If we want to know if we are good religious people or not, we ask ourselves, do we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the love of Allah in our hearts? And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says to us, the believers, utiru fa inna Allah yuhibb al-witr. At the end of the night, before we go to sleep, we pray al-witr. And al-witr is one rak'ah at the end of the day. So if we want to pray three rak'ahs, two shaf' and then one witr. So utiru, and this is, if we look at sunnat Rasulullah, all the sunan that al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prayed, there is two he never left. When he's sick or when he's traveling, the two that he held on was the two rak'ahs before al-subh and the witr at the end of the day. These are the two sunnas that in all circumstances the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never left it. Because when we're traveling, of course, we can't pray less. We can do qasr, and because we pray less. But even with the qasr, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the two sunnas was the two rak'ahs before al-subh and al-witr. And as the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, utiru fa inna Allah yuhibb al-witr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the witr, which is the odd numbers. And this is why when we say subhanallah, we say subhanallah either 11 or 33 times. Whatever we do in odd numbers, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the odd numbers. And then what else does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love? Inna Allah rafiq yuhibb al-rifq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is gentle and loves gentleness. Allah yuhibb abduhu al-mu'min. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the servant that's a believer. And that's who we should love. Subhanallah, our children today loves a movie star or a hockey player or a baseball player. Subhanallah, because we did not teach them to love the believers same as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves Abduhul Mu'min. And then it says, Abduhul Mu'min al-Faqir, the poor, al-Mutaffif, even though he's poor, he doesn't look at other people. He doesn't want to take from other people. Aba al-Hayal, he has children. Subhanallah, we've grown up in cultures that tell us, if you don't have money, don't have children. Or only have one or two children, because that's the ones you can bring up. When Islam tells us the opposite, Islam says, نَحْنُ نَرْزُقْهُمْ وَإِيَّاكُمْ. Allah provides for them and provides for you. And yes, our parents, if you ask, they say, they notice the more children they had, the more risk they have. But for us now, we worry so much. We worry about the risk, so that's why we say we don't want more children. We cannot educate them, we cannot feed them, we cannot. And this is against Islam. Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells them, نَحْنُ نَرْزُقْهُمْ وَإِيَّاكُمْ. Allah provides for them and provides for us, inshallah. What else does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love? Inna Allah yuhibbu samahu al-bay'a, samahu al-shira'a, samahu al-qada'a. Somebody when he buys, he's nice and gentle when he buys. He doesn't bargain forever. Yes, it's okay to bargain, but you don't have to bargain to take the least price or deprive the merchant from any profit he might make. Samah al-shira'a, when he buys, he's kind and gentle. Maybe he knows that the other person is making a little money and he lets it go because the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I remember a story when I was young, much younger than today, subhanallah. I was with an Australian friend in California and he went and bought an expensive shirt. And I told him, you could have bought it cheaper from this department store. He looked at me and he said, Ashraf, don't you think the owner of this store wants to make a living too? If none of us buys from him, how is he going to make a living? And at the time when I was young, I thought, look at this fool. He could have saved $10 and buy it from the department store. But now I realize, samahun fi shira'i. You know, yes, he forgives. And he's doing it to help somebody else. And that's what a community is about, is we help others. Yes, we know it might cost a little more, but he's doing it, even though he was a non-Muslim, but he's doing it to help others. And that's what we have to understand. In a community, we help others. It's not just about the cheapest price or the least price. We have to look and say, if we all of us don't help, we know, subhanallah, that this will close down. So we have to help each other. سَمَحُمْ فِي شِرَاءِ سَمَحُمْ فِي بَيْعِ. And when he sells, again, he's easy. He doesn't have to bargain a lot and, you know, gives it a reasonable price at a reasonable margin and profit, subhanallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves this person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yahibbu al-'atas wa akrahu al-tathaub. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves sneezing and dislikes yawning. And that's why when we yawn, we have to put our hand on our mouth because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dislikes yawning. As for sneezing, because we know Adam, the first thing he did when the soul started going in him, he sneezed. And he said, Alhamdulillah. He thanked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the angel said, Yarhamukum Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may Allah bless you. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, if a person says, Alhamdulillah, and they tell you, Yarhamukum Allah, who says, Hadakum Allah wa rahaba lakum, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide you and give you peace of mind. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yuhibbu al-'atas. Allah loves the sneezing and dislikes the yawning. Inna Allahu tayyib yuhibbu at-tayyib. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is kind and gentle and good and likes only good things. You can't just where you say somebody says I steal from somebody and then I give for the sake of Allah. Well, whatever he stole is not tayyib, it's not good. So he cannot give it for the sake of Allah because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only loves the tayyib. You can't say I take from somebody unjustly or wrongly and then I give for the sake of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala nazif yuhibbu an-nadafa, is clean and loves cleanness, subhanallah. And then we look in Islam, we find that Islam teaches us to wash 5 times a day. And if our clothes is dirty, we change our clothes before we pray, teaching us cleanliness. And yet how are we as Muslims? How clean are we? We have to ask ourselves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kareem yuhibbu al-karam, generous, and he likes generous people. Subhanallah, Allah is generous and he likes generous people. And that's where a kafir says, before he became a Muslim, I used to hate Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then when I became a Muslim and he just changed religion because everybody else changed, he went to Ar-Rasul and Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kept giving him generously. He said he kept giving me as if there is, the money never ends. And now I love him more than anybody else. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is kareem, kareem yuhibbul karam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the generous people. We have to be generous and do it for the sake of Allah. Don't try to outsmart anybody. We do, and we do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ اللَّهُ يُحِبَّ أَنْ يَرَى أَثَرْ نِعْمَتُهُ عَلَى عَبْدِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes to see that his blessings on you. If he gave you money or whatever he gives you, show it. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves to see this. A man came to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in kind of untidy old clothes. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you don't have money to buy nice clothes. He said, Ya Rasulallah, I don't care. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given me so much money, but I don't care about these things. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes to see his ni'mah on you. He given you, so let it show off on you. And this is what we amba bina'mat rabbika fahaddis. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you a blessing, you have to tell people. And you tell it in a nice way. And finally, سُلُوا اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ فَإِنَّ اللَّهُ يُحِبَّ أَنْ يُسْأَلْ وَأَفْضَلَ الْعِبَادَ انْتِزَارِ الْفَرَجِ. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from his bounties. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves that you ask him. So سَلُوا اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. We ask Allah for his fadl, and Allah loves that people ask. And then Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the best worship is you ask for something and wait for it. Even if you wait for years, subhanAllah, this is after al-ibadah. The worst, best worship of Allah is to wait that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you what you ask for, rather than say, I asked and I didn't get. And that's where Ibn Ata'illah al-Sakandari tells us in one of his wisdoms, never doubt that Allah will give you what you ask for. But be patient and be polite. Be patient in knowing that it will come. It doesn't matter if it comes in 10, 20, 30, 40 years. And be polite when you ask, subhanAllah. And don't say, I asked and I didn't get. So here, سِلُوا اللَّهَ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ إِنَّ اللَّهُ يُحِبَّ أَنْ يُسْأَلْ. Ask Allah. Whatever you want, ask Allah. It reminds me, I was walking with a brother, and he seen somebody in a very nice car, and he said, I get my pleasures in Al-Jannah, inshaAllah. I told him, well, if this is something good and you like, ask Allah. Ask Allah for it. We don't say a good sign that Allah loves us is we get what we want in the dunya and inshallah in al-akhirah, rather than say we deprive ourselves and we don't get in the dunya and say only we get our sawab in al-akhirah. And as we know that Prophet Ayyub alayhi salam, when he was patient, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him his money and his health and his children back double what he had. So this he gave him in the dunya before al-akhirah. So here inshallah we go back to khutbah al-Rasul, as a speech of al-Rasul in first Jum'ah al-Madina, أحب ما أحب الله. Love what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. And we have to ask ourselves, as we said, throughout all these things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves, do we love most of them? Do we love some of them? We have to be among that what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves and love what He loves. So same as when we love a person, we do what they like. أحب ما أحب الله. Love what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. أحب الله من كل قلوبكم. Love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with all your heart. Subhanallah. And if we know that when we love Allah, we'll get everything we want, why do we want anything else? Subhanallah. If we know that there's a rich person or somebody in position, we want to quickly go and meet them. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, رب العرش العظيم, the God and Lord of this great throne, if we love Allah and we love what He loves, He'll give us everything we ask. And try it. And try and you'll find that you get everything you ask. So you don't need this king or prince or. Only we need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we حب الله من كل قلوبكم ولا تملوا كلام الله. And do not get bored from the words of Allah. If you read the Quran and open your heart for it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lighten your heart and lighten your mind with the Quran. And also don't get bored from zikrillah. Subhanallah. When you say astaghfirullah, the hard things will be easy. When we thank Allah for anything, say alhamdulillah, shukrillah, we will get more. So why do we waste our time in not mentioning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And back home, sometimes I see somebody writing on the wall saying, don't waste any time waiting for something without istighfar and without zikrillah. And it reminds us, yes, I am waiting for a bus, waiting for an elevator, waiting for something. Why not at this time mention Allah and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because we get the sawab. وَلَا تَمِلُّ كَلَامَ اللَّهِ. For this is the speech of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that is what iman is about. You want to measure your iman, ask yourself how much do you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and how much do you love the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. And what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala find you? Where He loves to find you. Or does He find you where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, stay away and keep out of, subhanallah. So we do these tests on ourselves to know, and inshallah may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase our iman. Allahumma ahdina ya maulana fi man hadayt, wa'afina fi man afayt, waqina wasif anna sharra ma qadayt. اللهم بارك لنا فيما أعطيت، اللهم هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين، واجعلنا متقين إماما. ربنا اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم واستغفروه يغفر لكم. وأقم الصلاة.